Als wij het grote veld der Keltologie willen helpen exploreren, zullen wij een stage en hechte samenwerking moeten betrachten. Gij moet slechts komen als gij doorzettingsvermogen hebt en lust tot avontuur. If we want to help explore the large field of Celtic studies, we will have to aim for constant and close collaboration. You should only come if you possess perseverance and a sense of adventure. These words were uttered by Maartje Draak in 1946. She was to become a professor of Celtic studies at two Dutch universities, the University of Amsterdam and Utrecht University. She was also to become the first female member of the Dutch Royal Academy for the Sciences for the Department of Literature. And this citation by her, I think, perfectly illustrates why she was such an important figure in the field. Not only does she show herself to be a gifted speaker and storyteller, drawing in her audience with a glimpse of the adventure that may lie ahead, she is also stressing the importance of collaboration and the exchange of thoughts for scholarly work. Hi, my name is Nieke, and I work at the Dublin Institute for Advanced Studies at the School of Celtic Studies as a postdoctoral researcher. Like Maartje Draak, I'm a Dutch national, and I first came across the subject Celtic Studies at Utrecht University, where it has been taught since 1923. And today I'd like to talk to you a bit about Maartje Draak, because she was such a phenomenal woman. And I think you can tell by looking at this picture of her. Looking at it, it's just clear that she has things to say, and she's going to say them regardless. And it will come as no surprise to you then that she single-handedly saved the discipline just after the Second World War. This happened when the only professor of Celtic studies in the Netherlands at the time, Anton van Hamel, died unexpectedly, and the fate of the discipline rested on her shoulders. While devastated by the loss of her mentor, she managed to quickly and successfully find support, international support, for the discipline, thus ensuring the fact that it is still being taught today in Utrecht. But what I admire about her most, I think, is how well she took up the challenge. She instilled in people a sense of both the beauty and the importance of Celtic studies. And she did this by striking a very delicate balance between excellent scholarly work on the one hand and an accessible communication of this scholarly work with a broader audience on the other hand. And this is the reason why she's not only fondly remembered in the Netherlands by academics for her scholarly achievements, but also by the general public, because of the beautiful and accessible translation she made of early medieval Irish sagas, some examples of which I have here. So, for example, she translated the story of the Feast of Brikriu, Vlethvrikren, into Dutch, as well as some stories from the Tambo Kunje, or the cattle raid of Cully. So in striking this delicate balance, she was well ahead of her time, and we have her to thank for invigorating a small field in the Netherlands and for bringing early medieval Irish into the lives of so many.